Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about the surprising impact of medium-sized texts on Postgres performance. This is a blog post by Haki Benita that he wrote back in 2020, but I think it's a really good post that's worth revisiting. I was discussing recently with a colleague how to tune the toast tuple target setting that controls when toast takes effect, and I think this will be very useful to you in real-world workloads. To start with, Haki describes three different categories of text that you might find in your database. You might find small text, like username or emails. You might find large texts, like full blog posts or articles. And you might find this special category of medium texts, which could be things like descriptions or blog post comments or stack traces if you're tracking errors. Now, medium texts are the type that Haki found surprising performance behavior with in this blog post. To start with, Haki gives a quick overview of how toast works in Postgres. If you remember, Postgres structures its tables into pages, typically of 8 kilobyte size. If we have 1 megabyte of data, how do we store that in Postgres? That's where toast comes in. Toast is a mechanism where Postgres either compresses and or stores data out of line separately from the main table. That means once your text field exceeds the toast tuple threshold, by default set to 2 kilobytes, then toast will first try to compress things, and if the compression doesn't make it small enough, it will store it separately in what's called a toast table. Toast tables are usually something that you don't have to worry about when you're querying your database. When you do a query, Postgres will transparently read the data from toast whilst you're querying it. Now, toast performance is really why we're here. Let's look at the small, medium, and large texts and see how they perform. Here, Haki creates 500,000 records in 3 tables. In the first case, for a small table, is literally the string small value. In the second case, it's a 1.8 kilobyte random string, so it's just under the toast tuple target. And then in a large table, it's a 4 kilobyte random string, so it's clearly above the toast tuple target. For the first test here, we're selecting just one of the rows here, but note that we don't have any indexes here, we don't have any primary key, and so we're doing a sequential scan across the table until we find our matching row. Note also that we're matching on the ID column here, which is in the main table, not in the toast table. We can see here what Haki describes as a surprising performance behavior, and I think I would agree, which is that the small table is fast, the large table is fast, but the medium table is slow. And the reason the medium table is slow is because the medium table has a lot more data stored in the main table, versus the large table is roughly about the same size of the small table if you consider just the main table portion, with the actual text stored in a separate toast. And so when Postgres does that query, does that sequential scan, because it's matching on the ID column, it doesn't have to go to the toast table to find its matching row. It can stay in the main table, and only once it found that row, then it will look up the toast for just that one matching row. And so that's why large table performs much better here, is because you're essentially avoiding all the expense of reading over these text values that you don't actually need for the query. Now, of course, if you ran a test where you were looking for the value that's toasted, then the picture looks different. In this case, we can see that when we're doing a text comparison on the field that's small, medium, or large, then we'll actually see that large is the slowest because we actually have to look at all the toasted values. Medium is slightly better, and then small, of course, is a lot better. If you have indexes, of course, this picture changes a little bit. So in that case, if we do that comparison on the ID column, if that's indexed, that's going to be fast on all 3 types of columns. But oftentimes, indexes are not perfect matches, right? Oftentimes, an index just gives you an idea of where in the table to look for, because you might have a filter condition on the index, or you might be using other index types like Brin. And so in those situations, the more pages in the main table you have to look at, the more expensive it's going to be. And so in that case, that medium-sized text can really be a bad performance hit again. How can we avoid this problem? Now, there's 2 things you can do. You can either adjust the toast tuple target to have more values be considered for either toast compression or moving them out of line. This is something that, for example, here, Haki would set to 128 bytes, and that then would likely cause all of the medium table to behave like the large table, so that first performance test is going to be much faster. This is a table storage option that you can either set at the table creation time or you can change it for your existing table, but it would only apply to new values that are added to the table. And so to really see the performance benefit, you may need to rewrite your table, for example, by performing an insert into select into a temporary table, and then renaming the table. The other thing that Haki suggests here, and I think that's a good practice in general, is when you have these text values and you only need them sometimes, it's a good practice to just keep them in a separate table altogether, because that way the main table stays small, stays compact, and then only when you actually need that text, you will access it through that separate table. That, of course, will need application side changes, so Toast tuple target might be easier to implement. Overall, I would say that this can have significant performance benefit, especially for those heavily used tables that might be very large in size just because of the medium text. And so I would encourage you to take a look at your Toast table size and your data values to understand better whether you should adjust these settings. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week. Thank you.